Vidya was an instinct, which nobody agreed with. Her films had not done well at the time, and they didn't want to cast her. I shot the climax of the film on day three.
On day three,
and Sajid called me up and said, "Have you lost it? Have you lost your mind?" So if you look at a film like Kaho Na Pyar Hai, if you look at a film like Betab, if you look at a film like Hero, these are masterpieces for a debut.
Koimoi.com. Hello and welcome to Koimoi. This is Shubham Kulkarni, and today with me is the man who has given Hindi cinema some of its biggest entertainers, and he's here to talk about the next entertainer is about to give you. And here's the man himself. Hello, sir.
Hi.
First of all, it's your comeback after what, 4 years? It's kind of a comeback.
I think we take away about 18 months from the 4 years because of the pandemic. But everyone has had to wait.
When I see the trailer, it's the Jununi Ishq. There's this love story of two star-crossed lovers who find their redemption, maybe. Bollywood somehow stopped making these in the meanwhile. Tell me, what's the reason?
I don't know. You know, I did a lot of study about debut films. And I found that there were some that were very simplistically done. And there were some which had everything. So if you look at a film like Kaho Na Pyar Hai, if you look at a film like Betab, if you look at a film like Hero, these are masterpieces for a debut. And they had everything. They had music, they had romance, they had action, they had dialogues, they had stunning locations, they had intensity, great character actors. So I felt that's the template I want to follow. I want to pack it all into one film. And not just have it like a silken romance, you know, that, because that's not me. I mean, people have made wonderful films in that space also, but I need a lot of masala. I need to have everything on my plate. So one day I'm shooting action, one day I'm shooting a dramatic scene, one day I'm shooting a comedy scene, one day I'm shooting a beautiful song. That's what keeps me going. Otherwise I get bored. And if I get bored, then my audience is going to get bored. So it's a 2-hour ride. It's a roller coaster ride, and that's what we had intended from day one.
But then you have always worked with the biggest names there are in Bollywood, be it Bachchan sir, be it Ajay Devgan. Coming with a newcomer right here, does it require courage? What is it about?
You know, I don't think so much about this. I go by instinct. You know, sometimes you get it wrong, sometimes you get it right. But Vidya was an instinct, which nobody agreed with. Her films had not done well at the time, and they didn't want to cast her. But my instinct was very firm. At one point, I refused to do the film unless she was part of it. Yes. And then she had a problem with it. She took another month to say yes because it was a tricky part. And so it's just a gut feeling, you know. I mean, when I met Sajid at his office and he said, "This is the plan," I said, "Let me meet Ahan. Let me meet him. Let me just to be sure, let me test him a little bit." And the moment we started the test, I could sense that I have a very good actor in my hands. Not just a new boy. I have a very, very good actor. And I said, you know, I have achieved a few things that I wanted to achieve. I wanted to do a rugged film like Kacche Dhaage, or a very urban slick film like Taxi, or a prisoner of war film like Diwar. I wanted to do these films. I wanted to do a Once Upon a Time tribute to the 70s. I wanted to do a film driven by a woman, based on cinema. So I said, this is not yet in my repertoire. I haven't done a film with new actors. So this is the right time to do it. I can share with them some things that I have learned. I can share with them my experiences of how actors like Ajay and Amit Ji, Sanju, Akshay, Vidya, how they cope with the stress of filming. And they don't let the stress affect the performance. How we laugh and fool around on the set, we play cricket, we have a bonfire in the evening, we sing songs, we get into that frame of mind so that the pressure doesn't build up, because if the pressure builds up, the performance goes down. So I shared a lot of anecdotes with them while shooting and kept them in good spirits. Both of them are very fine actors. Tara has a lot of experience. Ahan is a natural. Ahan adapts very fast. So when you know, a good actor is one who listens very carefully to his director and does what the director wants, whether it be a legend like Mr. Bachchan or other senior actors who I've worked with. They listen very well. You know, they understand that they have come today, but the director has been working for a year. So I always say that anybody who listens well will perform well. And Ahan is a great listener. He'll sit quietly, he'll absorb everything, and one small correction and he's there. I've done scenes 1.5, 2, 3 pages without a cut. Intense, dramatic scenes. I shot the climax of the film on day three.
On day three,
and Sajid called me up and said, "Have you lost it? Have you lost your mind? How can you shoot the climax? It's a very dramatic, very emotional climax." And I said, "No, I'm okay. I'll do it. I know he'll do it." And when we finished that scene, even Ahan was like, "So I can't believe we did this." So I said, "There you go. Now you take your confidence from here. On day three, if you can shoot the last scene of the film, then you know that the rest of it is going to be easy." So, yeah, of course, then there were things like tricks of the trade. You know, it's difficult to ride a bike around the mountains and at the same time emote and look good. And so helped him along, helped Tara along a little bit. But most of it is them. I'm just a zariya to bring them to this point. The rest is all up to them. And they're both very captivating on screen. You can't take your eyes off them.